So, sasabi ni Susilu Malorca, tinatanong niya tayo how to invest in crypto. And ang pwede kong isagot kay Susilu, bibigyan kita ng tips and probably a step-by-step na rin na sana ito yung gawin mo. Okay? So the first step, if you want to invest in crypto, is to learn how cryptocurrencies work. Particularly, I hope you can familiarize yourself with how blockchain technology works. Okay, importante kasi do not invest on something that you don't understand. Never invest in something that you don't understand. Kasi kapag hindi mo alam kung paano nag-work ang cryptocurrencies, kung paano nag-work ang blockchain technology, ay madali kang maluloko kasi may mga scammers sa crypto currencies. Eh. May scammers sa crypto industry. So, kapag hindi mo naintindihan kung ano yung pinapasok mo, madali kang maluloko ng ibang tao. Pangalawa, meron tayong makikita na mga iba't ibang strategies siguro on how to make money in cryptocurrencies. And if you understand what you are going into, it will be easier for you to discover or to find a investing or even trading strategy in cryptocurrency na fit sa'yo. Pangalawa, with cryptocurrencies, I'll mention this later, no, na you have to open an account with a platform, with you have to download an app. You have to deal with a lot of third-party software. And kung hindi mo alam kung ano yung pinapasok mo, kung ano yung how everything works, it will be easy to lose money because of mistakes. So, just an example or an overview, no? Siyempre, sa cryptocurrency, usually, nasa decentralized finance yan. Yung ginagawa mo, you buy crypto, pupunta sa crypto wallet mo, sa tinatransfer mo sa crypto exchange yan, tapos mini-withdraw mo sa bank account mo, etc., no? So maraming transfer of money. Ngayon, usually merong gas fees yan or transaction fees na hindi fixed. Depende kung anong oras, depende sa demand. Tapos very strict pa yan dun sa mga addresses. So kung hindi mo naintindihan kung paano yan nag-work, mas prone ka to error. And ang isang risk pagdating sa cryptocurrencies, kapag nagkamali ka ng send, or nagkamali ka sa isang step, pwedeng mawala yung crypto mo, yung pera mo. So, unless you really have a good understanding of how cryptocurrencies work, how the blockchain technology works, then kailangan alam mo muna siya before ka talaga maglagay ng totoong pera mo. Okay, so that's really your first step. And if you want to learn about crypto and blockchain, marami na rin mga resources ngayon online na pwede mong panoorin na videos at saka mga articles na pwede mong basahin. Okay? My second tip for you is to learn the difference between trading and investing. So, very important kasi ang trading at saka investing, magkaiba ang strategies niyan. So, pwedeng, may mga naririnig kasi ako eh na invest in crypto, tapos pag pinakinggan mo, ang ibibigay sa'yo na strategies, pang trading. So, ikaw, you want to invest in crypto, ang mindset mo ay bibili mo siya, tapos you hold it, kasi nga, investing. Pero yung pinakinggan mo, ang binigay sa'yo yung tip is trading, na ito dapat yung bilhin mo, kasi these are good cryptos that to hold for the short term. Kasi nga, you're just trading eh, di ba? So, mahirap kapag ganon. So, for example, yung Dogecoin. Dogecoin is a meme coin na ever since, I believe it's a trading crypto, no? So, short term lang yan. I don't expect or I don't see any sense na bibili ka ng Dogecoin tapos i-hold mo siya for several years. Hindi siya for investing. It's really for trading. Ikaw, ang dami mo nakikita na bumibili ng Dogecoin, akala mo investing yon. So you bought Dogecoin, nag-invest ka sa kanya, ang mindset mo ay long term. So mali na kagad. So know the difference between trading and investing, and ma-discover mo na iba yung mga trading strategies at iba yung mga investing strategies. Not just in crypto, but also in stocks and in forex. Number three is to decide on the goal and develop a strategy. So again, ano ba yung goal mo? Para sa akin, pagdating sa crypto, ang best goal would be to make quick returns, to be honest. Kasi I still believe that cryptocurrency is a trading asset. So kung gusto mo kumita sa crypto, talagang trading ang gawin mo. You can invest, pero don't expect a lot or don't expect that you'll make money sa investing kasi it's bordering on speculation because we're still unsure of the future of cryptocurrencies. Hindi pa rin natin alam kung gaano siya. We still don't know if its utility will eventually become mainstream. We are banking or we have conviction on the utility of blockchain technology, but on specific cryptocurrencies, I unfortunately cannot give any commitment, no, na for sure aakyat ito. I cannot have that commitment. All I can give is based on historical data and of course dun sa plans nung founders or developers of a particular crypto ay mukhang maganda naman yung plano. So we are investing on the founder's vision, on the capability or the potential of the coin, no, or the crypto. So again, it's important to decide on a goal and develop a strategy. Also because baka mamaya yung goal mo ay pwede mo naman palang ma-achieve through other assets na mas mababa ang risk. For example, meron kang 100,000, ang goal mo rito ay maging 200,000 siya after let's say 10 years. Tagal, no? Pero I believe na if you invest that money in the stock market for 10 years, assuming that you really buy probably blue chip companies or something na talagang maganda yung growth potential, you'll be able to double yung value nung stock investment mo in less than 10 years and you'll be able to achieve your goal. So, syempre, the stock market is less risky than cryptocurrency. So, baka instead of investing your money in crypto, mas maganda na sa mutual fund or sa stock market na lang. So, it's important to know what your goal is. Why do you want to put money in crypto? At hindi pwedeng rason yung gusto mo lang na naku-curious ka lang, no? Hindi pwede yon. It's okay, kuwari ang goal mo ay you just want to diversify your portfolio, then I think that's a good enough reason to invest in crypto, to have some form of diversification. But syempre, pagdating sa strategy, I always believe na you should not invest more than 10% of your portfolio in crypto assets. So siguro mga 5% lang. Ako nagsimula lang ako ng 5%, tapos minomonitor ko kung ilang percent na ng portfolio ko yung crypto assets ko. Kapag lumampas na ng 10%, I liquidate or I redeem some of my holdings sa crypto, tapos yung pera I invest in a mutual fund or in the stock market, no? So yun, meron akong weight na mini-maintain sa portfolio ko ng crypto assets ko. That's one of my strategies pagdating doon sa ginagawa kong pag-hold ng some of the crypto assets. Next tip ko is to join Facebook groups and Discord channels kasi maraming mga very educational, helpful na mga Facebook groups, but especially Discord channels, Discord communities who discuss cryptocurrencies and especially mga NFT project. Isa sa mga, if you're going to invest in crypto, one of the more popular assets to invest on are yung mga NFTs. Again, highly speculative ang NFTs, but there are NFTs na maganda yung utility, meron na kagad current benefits, and of course there are also NFTs na medyo charitable ang vision and mission and etc. But NFTs are still crypto assets or mga blockchain assets pa rin yan. And yung mga discussion sa mga Discord channels or Discord communities nila, very helpful kasi there's always a room or a channel na nagbibigay ng mga educational content pagdating sa crypto and NFTs. So kung hindi ka familiar sa Discord nako, balik tayo dun sa tip number one natin na learning how crypto and blockchain works kasi yung Discord, ano yan, social network, you can call that so a social network na favorite ng mga crypto enthusiasts. So as you become more familiar with crypto and blockchain, you'll also discover kung saan ba nakatambay ang mga yan. You'll probably stumble upon mga ano ba yung Reddit na website, na ano ba yung Reddit forums, paano ba nag-work yung Discord, etc. Okay? And lastly, open an account in trusted apps and platforms. Ako, napakaraming promote sa timeline mo probably. Ewan ko, kasi may mga bots for some reason, ang galing nilang mag-sniff ng mga tao online who are interested in Forex or in crypto. Maski sa ating YouTube channel at Facebook page, minsan may makikita kayong comment kung sino-sino na nagpo-promote ng app or nagsasabi na i-message nyo ako, I will give you an investment opportunity, I will teach you how to make money in crypto. Nako, be very careful. Always open an account or download apps na popular na. And paano mo malalaman kung ano ba yung mga popular, ano ba yung mga trusted? Again, dun sa previous tip natin sa mga Facebook groups at saka sa mga Discord channels. Tanungin mo ano ba yung ginagamit nila, saan sila may account. So ako, of course, I have an account with Binance, I have an account with PDAX, and sa wallet, meron tayong MetaMask, and some other wallets. No? So, again, hindi ko na i-repeat yung mga sinabi ko. You do your own research. Favorite yan ng mga crypto enthusiasts. So, DYOR. Do your own research. Kasi very important na kung ano man yung gagawin mo, lalo na pagdating sa crypto industry or crypto space, ay dapat naiintindihan mo and dapat ay may sarili kang conviction dun sa actions mo. So, yun ang ating limang tips sa'yo. Furthermore, meron tayong YouTube video. This was a Q&A in a previous live stream. So, Sushi Luno, pwede mong i-search ito sa ating channel. Yung, do I invest in cryptocurrencies? So, my thoughts and advice to those who want to try. Okay, so, hanapin mo ito. At syempre, yung mga nanonood ngayon, hanapin nyo na rin itong video na to kasi meron tayong mga additional tips dito. And I recall na I shared yung specific strategy na ginagawa ko.